Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's Loreja Andrea, and I'm giving you guys another video this week. I'm going to be giving you guys consistent videos for the next like 2 weeks before my surgery, so they're going to be practically back to back. So in this video, I'm showing you guys a natural makeup routine and also my natural curly hair routine. I'm using practically all products from 12 View. You guys may or may not have seen these products in my last natural hair straightening video. If you have not seen that video, go ahead and check it out because it's bomb. But these products are actually made by the owner from Laid Hair Boutique in Philadelphia. Her and her husband have opened up this company and they're amazing. This is the only product that I have ever tried that has defined my curls like this and keeps my hair super moisturized. So all I do is just shampoo and condition my hair off camera, and then I also use the leave-in hair mist from them and I just pat it in. I do not rake it through my hair because I do not want to alter my curls. Then I will go in with Beyond the Zone, their noodle head spray. This is a curling activating spray, and I just sprayed pretty much the entire head, and then I also go through and per section and just spray this as well. This does a really good job with keeping my curls intact. One problem I always had was that my hair never kept the definition of my curls, and using these products really keep my definition of my curls and make sure that my hair stays intact. Then I'm going to go in with Pure Growth. It is a hair oil serum, and I'm going to use that to give me some added shine to my little fro, and I'm just going to pat that into. Then I'm just going to take a portion of the hair, which is going to be like my bang portion, and clip it back. Try not to be too heavy-handed, but I pretty much just clip it back to get away from my eyes. And then I'm going to go in with some Miracle 5 from Smashbox. I love to use their lip oil, and I love to use their priming oil for my face. My skin is very dry right now. You guys may see that my dermals are out. Yes, I had to take my dermals out for my surgery. No metal in the surgery room, so dermas are out and are practically staying out because I just feel like I just like my face a little bit better without the dermals. I don't know, maybe it's a 2020 thing, but dermals are staying out. I'm just going ahead and moisturizing my face using this primer oil because it's bomb and my skin is dry, and it really does a good thing with moisturizing. Speaking of dry skin, I'm going to go in with the Fenty Beauty Hydrating Primer. You guys have seen me use this primer so many times, and I just love to use this primer, honestly. I'm then going to go in with the Precisely My Brow in the number 4 from Benefit, and I'm just going to fill in my brows. And one thing that I like to do is just take the Anastasia Dip Brow in the shade Ebony, because that helps me define my brows, especially for camera portraits. If I know I'm taking Instagram pictures, I would just go in with this product, and it just helps me define my brows. Because if not, on a daily basis, I would just use the Benefit, but if I know I'm taking pictures, I will go in with the Anastasia as well, because it really shows up super good in my photos. Then I'm going to go ahead and define my brows with the Fenty Beauty concealer in the shade 410. I love this concealer. You guys have seen me use this concealer so many different times. I love to actually use the applicator to do my brows. I don't really know why. I just love the fact that it does a really good job with getting the product on my brows and also just defining my brows. It's just bomb, you guys. I don't know why I love it so much. I actually love using that more than I like to use an actual concealer brush. I'm going to be using an OG of foundations, the LA Girl Pro Coverage Foundation in the color Toast. I honestly forgot how bomb this coverage is, number one, and I also forgot how bomb this shade is, sis. This is like my perfect shade, the only foundation that I honestly have the perfect shade in. No other foundation has my perfect shade. I have to practically mix every single foundation out on the market, and this is the only thing that actually is perfect for me. I'm then going to go in with Born This Way from Too Faced in the color Chai. I'm going to be using two concealers. This is like an everyday type of natural foundation routine or just makeup look in general. It's not technically like everyday for the more natural girls. It's just like a natural beat. And I want to go in with the second concealer to give me a bright highlight effect. The same 15 concealer, but just in the color 360. And I'm just going to give an added highlight underneath my eyes, on my nose, and also on my chin. Then I'm going to go in with yet another Fenty concealer, this time in the color 445, and I'm just going to use that to cut the upper part of my brows. Again, like I said, it does a really good job with chiseling out my brows in photos, because if I do not do this, my brows literally are non-existent. On an everyday basis, I won't do this. I'll just use my brow pencil, but like I said, just for Instagram photos, I will do the extra steps of doing this to my brows. Then I will just take my fan that I got from Anastasia Alyssa Edwards collection and just let my concealer dry a little bit, and then I'll move on to blending out my concealer. I will link this brush from Morphe Brushes down below, but you guys, seriously, you need this brush. This brush has changed my entire concealer game. It is so dense. It packs on so much product when I blend out my concealer. Number one, adding on to letting it dry a little bit. But seriously, this brush has changed my entire concealer game. And I will also just blend it out with a beauty blender. This is the Colored Rain Beauty Blender from their Christmas collection. I will link that down below. Colored Rain, you guys, I love their products. And on top of that, they're Black owned. But I've been loving that for blending out my foundation and blending out my concealer from the brush. And then I'll also use that for doing my powder. The powder I used was from Huda Beauty and the color Blondie. And then I will go in using my Fenty Matte Matchsticks in the color Truffle and Espresso to contour my nose as well as contour my cheeks. I would just go ahead and blend out all of that contour with an angled brush from Morphe. Then I will go ahead and blend out my nose contour as well. I will actually link all of my Morphe brushes down below, because I honestly feel like my entire foundation game has changed since I use certain Morphe brushes. But yeah, then I'm gonna go ahead and fill in my brows just a little bit more, just filling in any parts that I kind of messed up with my foundation. Then I will use my favorite bronzer of all time right now. This is a Prime Beauty Brownsville bronzer. Honestly, it's like the perfect contouring bronzer ever for deeper skin tones or just women in color in general. They have so many different colors, and I will also link this company down below. I will just link every single company down below that I use in the order of me using it. I will go in with my MAC Studio Fix powder in NC45. This just gives me an added brightness to my under cheeks and just any under cheeks, to my under eye, and anywhere where I just put my concealer in general. I would just go in with my L'Oreal Ebony bronzer for my cheeks, and then I will just spray my face with my Morphe setting spray, and then I will go in with my Bobbi Brown highlight. I believe this is in like pink glow or something like that. Yeah, it's just like the most most natural highlight ever. It's so bomb on my skin tone. Now I'm going to be doing my eyes. The eyes is going to be like fairly simple, but still gives us a little bit of like a oomph. So I'm going to go in with that same Fenty concealer that I use in 360 underneath my eyes for brightness. And we're going to use that to put for our eyeshadow primer. I seriously love using the Fenty concealers for concealing as well as using as an eyeshadow primer. I know she has like an eyeshadow primer, you know, separately, but I love to use the concealer instead. Then I'm going to go in with my favorite powder. This is my favorite loose translucent powder ever. This is the Becca Hydra Mist in Golden Bronze. I use it to set my foundation, and I also use it as a crease color for my eyeshadows. It has like a slight tint to it. It's like the perfect shade for my foundation color as well as putting in my transition color. Then I'm going to go in with this MAC. I believe this is a MAC liquid eyeshadow. I know I got it from last year's MAC Christmas collection. I will link it down below because it may or may not still be available. But guys, this is such a pretty, beautiful color. Like, oh my gosh, it looks like straight wetness on my eyes, but the color complements my skin tone so well. It's like the perfect everyday natural type of eyeshadow look. If you want to be effortless, you want to still look a little bit glammed, but you don't want to look like too much. Meow, meow, meow. And then I'm just going to go in with that same bronzer from Prime Beauty that we use on our cheeks. And I'm just going to buff that into my crease using a big blending brush. And it just gives us like the most effortless eye look, but it still just, you know, defines our eyes, but just gives a little bit of like a, you know what I mean? Then I'm gonna go in with the NYX Matte Liquid Liner. Just to lightly define our eye. We're not doing a wing or anything because we're doing pretty naturally dramatic lashes. The lashes are going to be from Fairy Stylish and the style Kiana. But first, we're going to be using some mascara from Too Faced. I believe it's like the big mascara or something like that. I'll link it down below. I don't remember the exact name of it. But again, like I said, these are the Fairy Stylish lashes and Kiana. I used these in my video when I did my bedhead spray video, and you guys kept asking me what type of lashes they were, and these are the same ones from that video. And then lastly, we're just finishing up the video using my MAC lip liner in Chestnut, my all-time favorite lip liner ever. And I'm just going to be doing, this is pretty much the same look that I did in my bedhead video, but yeah, all I do is just put on the lip liner and use a paper towel just to blot my lips, and it just kind of takes away a lot of the lip liner in the center of my lips. And all I do is just put on some lip glosses from Morphe and Frosse, my favorite lip gloss ever. And I just put that on. It just gives like the most effortless, like pretty defined lip look. It's just so freaking bomb. And then I'm just going to go ahead off camera and put on my contacts. I'm doing a whole video, you guys, explaining my contacts, how I like to put in my contacts, what tool I use because I have super long nails. And I'm also doing a giveaway. I'm giving away 8 contacts to 8 winners in that video. So I will explain what contacts I like to wear, as well as giving away a ton of different contacts if you guys is choosing, because I will show you guys probably about 8 to 10 contacts in the video, and 8 winners will be able to choose whatever contacts they want. So yeah, that's going to be a very good video, but definitely stay tuned for that. Now I'm just going to be picking out my hair. I let my hair dry the entire time I was doing my makeup. This is pretty much the same order that I do my hair and makeup all the time when I'm being natural. I'll go ahead and put in my products, do my makeup, and then I will come back when my hair is pretty much dry, and I will just pick it. So I don't pick the ends of my hair because, again, the same thing of how we put in the products, we don't want to alter the ends and mess mess up the curls on the ends. So I would just pick the roots of my hair to make it big, because my hair can be pretty flat sometimes. And I would just use the pick to give me volume to my hair. And then I would just use my hair just to kind of, you know, frame my hair a little bit, make it like a little bit messy, but still not alter the curls any bit. And I would just literally continue to do this until I like the volume of my hair. And that's pretty much it. My hair does dry a little bit more later on in the video when I have my white shirt on. But this is pretty much the end of the video, you guys. I hope you guys really liked it. Definitely something different than wigs. I've been doing wigs pretty much back to back to back, and it feels good to get back to my natural roots of my whole YouTube, because again, you guys, I started with natural hair. I feel like some people forget that. Some people that are new don't even understand that I started with natural short hair. So if you guys were an OG Laurasia Andrea viewer, and you guys have been watching me since I had my bleached blonde short baldy, you guys are definitely OGs. Let me know in the comment section if you guys have been here since my short hair days. But this is how long my hair has gotten. Even with it being a year since I decided that I wanted to grow my hair out, I'll actually link that video down below of when I decided that. I decided that in July of 2018. So for me to go from like a short baldy to now is insane. I don't even think you guys understand how long my hair has gotten in just a year time. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm so happy with my end results of my hair, and yeah, hope to see you guys in my next video. Love you guys. Bye.